workload. So tell me, if you are designing a class and there is a dog, like as you know, so you want to add some, like dog can walk and dog can, you know, run. Tell me, as long as walk and run, that's fine, right? But customer requirement is, you know, we are able to make dog with different color, you know it, right? Using constructor and all. But requirement is, new customer comes to me. He said, I know you have dog which can walk and run, right? And dog can has different price, you know, towel and color. No, we know that, right? Not a problem. We can do that. We have template. But requirement is, you know, he wants new dog with different behavior. Means he does not want dog. We should walk and run only. He want dog should jump. Jump. Got it. So requirement is he wants a dog, but that dog should jump. Extra behavior, right? So what is the solution of it? We have two solution, couple of solution. First solution is go and modify the existing template. You know what I'm saying? Whatever class you have. Suppose in this class already we have probably void run. Probably void run. Public void walk and jump. Yeah, with me, you can add this method here. Tell me, this solution will solve your purpose. Guess. Not applying.
Yes.
But problem with this, if you use this template for new functionality, old customer will also get this functionality. Yes, you know?
Yes.
Right? So this solution is not correct because contract is contract. You are not supposed to provide this functionality anybody else by the, you know, free of cost, right? Yes. So modifying existing template isn't not, it's bad, right? Because sometime people might need old functionality, right? Walk and they need dog which should run and walk only. They should not jump at all. So this solution is not
not good
solution, right? Second solution, maybe you can make an entirely new template, okay? Class walk dog, any new class you can make, and like in this what you can do, same way, man, you just make a new class, but you are copying your old content and new content. You are duplicating a whole thing, right? You are duplicating it, making redundant. You tell me, what about this solution? This solution seems to be even more better, right? So you have two templates. You got a point? I got confused. One is for this two functionality and one is for three functionality. So, but solution is okay. But what is the problem with the solution is? Here we are, duplicating whole code. That's problem, right?
Yeah.
Third solution is, if you make a new class like walk dog, you are not copying code physically. You are doing inheritance, extends, and dog. You see, tell me. In this way, and in this you are adding new method, probably void jump. Tell me, what about this? In this, yeah. Neither you are modifying the existing functionality, nor you are copying everything here blindly, no? Extend means you want to say, I want to use all the code present in this logically, not physically. I want to copy, reuse it, something like that. So tell me, which solution seems to be nice among all the three? third one is called inheritance.
Yes.
So inheritance is one of the main pillar of OOPS concept. Done. Let's see the definition of inheritance. Inheritance is a mechanism which allows subclass
to inherit attribute and behavior.
Yeah, to inherit the attribute and that's fine. Your question may be, what is a subclass and what is a superclass? Allows. See.
Subclass inside.
Yeah. In this super dog is a super class, parent class, and subclass means child class, like walk dog. Here extends, right? So dog is
parent
super class. Yeah, or you can say parent class. Walk child class.
Child class.
Normally we say subclass in Java. That's it. This is a typical concept of inheritance. So inheritance allows reusability of the code also. Think and tell me. Inheritance allows reusability If you want to reuse the code, you can use inheritance. Any question, query, if anybody has, that's clear.
Yeah.
So I can show you some program. Can you see this? For inheritance program, I can make a new project for you. New Java project. Inheritance. Look here, I want to use the dog. I'm just showing you. No problem, I can make everything from the scratch. Here I'm making class dog, and dog can have name Jackie. Yeah, here if you want, you can use constructor also, right? Constructor benefit is you can have different name and everything. Price. So I'm just making very simple. Public void walk. Dog can walk. Dog can
run. Jump.
Run, right?
Yes.
This we have. What else I need to do? Here I can add one more method. which can show you the info of the dog. You know, public means this method can be accessed from anywhere outside the package, inside the package. As long as I am not teaching you package, everything is cool for you. Name equals to name. And I can, hey, this is clear or something very vague, which is not clear. Please let me know. Please reply.
Clear, it's clear.
It's clear. So we have walk, we have run, we have info. It's done. Now I need to make a new class, right? Jump dog or dog jumper, dog jump, anything you can make it, right? G dog. In this, you should have only one method, probably void jump. This out. Dog is jumping. It's clear. And you tell me in this JDog, how many method we have? Only one method or three method?
One.
Only one method. In this, how many method we have total? Total we have four, three. One, two, three. Now, if you extend it, what happened? Then this dog has how many method?
Four.
Four method, because everything, whatever we have dog, everything is inherited in J dog until and unless. Attribute is not a private. If attribute is private, right? Then that won't be inherited, right? Which attribute will be not inherited at all? Well, by not inherited. Any guess? Private. You got confused or you understand?
We understand.
Okay. Which attribute will be not inherited? Private. Done. See, now we have to make a main method. Main method I can make here also, right? So main method I can make anywhere. I can make inside dog, I make an inside J dog, or I can make even new class itself. Dog main. And in this, main is the starting point of the program. That's it. Why main is static? Because this is the starting point of the program. Clear? Main is starting point of the
program.
So it is static because you can delete. Why it is static? It is static so that we can, so that JBM can call. JBM can call it directly, directly with the help of class name. Makes sense or you got confused? Main is the starting point of the program. No need to make the object of the class dog main, then call it. That's why you make it static. Main is the starting point of the program. It is static so that JBM can call it directly with the help of class name. That's it. Why public? So that, you know, so that we can call it anywhere. Why it means? No need to return any value. No need to return any value to the caller. And this is called command line argument. I will teach you, right? This is used to take command line input. fine. Anybody have any question, query? Yeah, everything is crystal clear.
Okay.
Now here, first of all, I want to make an object of dog. So what do you need to do? See, in inheritance, parent is always independent, right? Yeah. Parent is always independent. Mm-hmm. Independent, right? But child is not independent, right? Child always has dependency on
parent,
right? Because inheritance is always unidirectional. Parent says, I don't care about child. I do not have any relationship with child. But child says, no. I am completely dependency on parent. I cannot come without
parent.
That's correct. Done. So if with the help of D, I can call which method? I can call all the three methods. D dot, run. D dot work. And D dot info. Then, no? But I cannot call D dot jump. No. See, you have to remember the rule, guys. Method call always depend on left side. What is it? Method calls always depend depends on left side. This rule is important. If you remember this, you can answer any kind of questions. Like here, you can call a method or not. It depends on the left side reference type, right? You open it and see method. If method is there, you can call it, right? You see why you cannot call gem? You will go and see the reference type, right? D reference type, dog type. In this, we don't have method. That's why you cannot call it. Got it? And definition will always come from the right side. Definition, right? Of method will always be lookup right side class. I'll tell you why. Your question may be, Nagendra, left side and right side class is always same. No, I'll show you something. Okay. So what you have to mark, method will be called or not, it will be decided by left side. And right definition will come from the right side. Please remember it. Yeah. But if I make object of
dog. Dog.
Yeah, J dog.
J dog.
Wow, story is different. J dog. In this case, what happened? Like here, J dog can access all the method. Like this. That's correct, right? J dog means it is not in J dog. You have to go to the parent. J dog is saying I have a method from my class as well as my parent class. And next you can call it
jump.
Done. If you see this program, you'd be saying it is straightforward. Nothing is special in this. If you want to, you can make a separator. So it's out. This is a separator. Run it. You see? Dog can run. Dog can walk. And you are printing the name and price of the dog. And here we have same. Any question, query if you have?
Query.
Pardon?
No queries.
Okay. I'm going to tell you another important rule. What rule is? I may have this diagram. See, let's focus on this class dog and name and tell. That's fine. In my example earlier, it was, I think, color and price, but that's fine. Name Tommy, tell. This dog has two methods, run and walk. And I'm creating another dog, bark dog, exchange dog, public white bark. So example is similar, right? Only difference is in this, we have bark, and in other example, it was jump. Then I'm creating aha main method. Public steady white main string. This name should be ARGS, or it could be anything. Any guess?
Maybe any.
Pardon?
Maybe it could be any.
It could be anything. That's why I wrote here as. It's fine. Like here, there's a rule. Superclass can reference our variable can hold reference as a subclass object. We need to understand what is the meaning of it. If I'm creating a reference, this is fine. You know what is the meaning of it? DD? DD is the reference of
dog.
Dog. Means it is a pointer to dog object. So in here you can write new, and here you can write bark dog. You know what is special I'm doing? Mister, you see, this is possible, right? Just a second, please. Just a second. You need to understand the meaning of it. That's it. In Java, in case of especially inheritance, you can make a reference of super, and this super can hold address of subclass object. This thing is clear, or you got confused? This is the rule. See.
Okay.
This is subclass reference, and here you are creating, sorry, here's superclass reference, and here we have subclass object. The meaning is superclass can reference, superclass reference, a variable can hold a reference of subclass object. My dog DD, this is correct? It is already holding the object, reference of the dog object. That's correct, right? That is the normal thing which you know. But what is the special about it? Any guess? Special is, superclass reference can hold a reference object of superclass as well as object of subclass. It is true in inheritance only.
Okay.
Oh, right. It is kind of violating the inheritance, right? Violating the normal rule. In normal rule, if you have dog reference, it should point to the dog object. But what happened here? It has a superclass reference, but it holds like super. Super class, na? Reference variable, na? Can hold reference of subclass object.
But it can be opposite.
Opposite is not possible. Opposite is not possible, right? Only this way is possible. Like superclass can hold, but subclass reference cannot hold superclass object reference. You got a point?
Yes.
That's cool. Now we need to understand the limitation. If superclass reference variable can hold object of subclass, right? So see, subclass object has more feature, more behavior, but subclass has limited. Subclass has more features, but superclass reference variable minimal. So you talk about something, right? Even though dog D equals to new bark dog, but D, right? Dog type. I told you, right? Whatever method you can call depend on left side. Left side will decide which method you can call, not right side. Right side only will give the definition. So if you want to call a method, first of all, it's important you can call it or not. For example, dog D. In dog D, we can call walk. That's fine. Why? In dog D, you see D walk. So you will go and check in dog. In dog, we have walk. Yeah. So we can call it, right? But what about bark? In D means dog. We have bark. You see, we don't have. A left side will decide we can call method or not.
Okay.
What? Left side will decide whether we can call method or not. Right side only if method is left side decide method is called. If it is yes, then definition will come from the right side. So you understand? A question is why I am teaching all those things, confusing topic. I will let you know tomorrow. Tomorrow means in next session. Okay. Why? Oh, cool. Right. The definition of the method will come from the right side always. If I make an object of bark dog, I can call all the method, right? But here you can only call the method from which is defined in dog only. Makes sense or you got confused here? Why bark cannot call? Anybody tell me? Because rule says superclass can point an object of subclass. That's fine. But superclass can call only those methods which are declared in the dog. Even though it here, if you see bark is present in bark dog. That's fine. But it is not available in the left side. That's why you cannot call it. This point is clear. I need to clarify more about it. Please tell me.
Yeah, it's clear.
See, assigning superclass, assigning subclass object into superclass reference, it is called upcasting. You see what I'm doing here? Dog D. In D, I'm assigning the object of subclass. It is possible, right? We just talked about. Superclass reference variable can hold address of subclass object. Superclass reference variable can hold reference of subclass type. Every reference has a type. Please remember in Java. What do you say? Every reference has a type. Of course, right? Every address has a type. Address means every reference has a type. Every address has a type, and in Java, reference can be typecast. What is it? Every reference has a type. And reference can be typecast. Please, you tell me you got this point or not? Important. Only you can typecast the reference, not object. Reference can be typecast only, not object. Hey, can you typecast object? Answer is no. Only you can typecast the address of the object. One address can be typecast into other reference type or address type, whatever. You see here? Hey, why it is called upcasting? Because dog D superclass is going to point subclass. So when you create new bark dog, it is creating a reference of bark dog type and reference of the subclass you assign to the superclass. That's why it is called upcasting. And please remember, if there is upcasting, you can make downcasting also. So for downcasting, which is important? Upcasting. Please reply what I said. For upcasting, what is required?
For downcasting.
Sorry, for downcasting, upcasting is required. Let me show you downcasting. You need to tell me this is correct or not. After that, I'll talk to you. Dog, the kindly help me. We have dog D and D equals to. Can you help me? Can I do that? Bark dog. I'm saying, can you do that? Yeah. Right, reply. We just talked about superclass can reference an object of subclass. Or in, can I write like this also? This is wrong. I'm sorry about it. Can we write like this also, if you allow me? BD. And this D can take BD. Any guess? Hello? That's correct. D is a reference of dog type. And here I'm creating an object of bark dog and holding, assigning to the bark DB. And this bark dog BD, I'm assigning to the D. Is perfectly fine. Earlier we were doing in one line. Now I did it in two lines, kind of. You, what you said, thing is correct, or what you got confused? People, I'm waiting for you. This is correct. Reply, then I'll come to know, right? You got this much, or I got confused? Subclass reference you are assigning to superclass reference variable. Not clear. It is the example of upcasting or downcasting?
Upcasting.
Okay, my next question to you is, in this situation, can I make this call? You have to say yes or no. Can I call here D dot, help me, D dot bark, it is correct?
No. Not correct.
Not correct, because bark is not available in D. D means dog type. No, it's not there, that's why. So this will give you compile time error, because compiler will come to know, hey, it's not there. But like here, down the line, what I can do, it is possible. This D is pointing to BD, right? So D can be further typecast. Further typecast? Yeah. If it is required, then this D can be downcast, right? Why? Because already it is pointing to bark dog. Then you can downcast it. Can you see this? It's possible. D is pointing to whom already? D is pointing to BD. BD means bark dog type. Then you can downcast it like this. Yeah. This is called downcasting. This is called downcasting. And for downcasting, upcasting is required. If upcasting is not there, then there is no question of downcasting. Okay. Up, tell me here, I can call this method now, bt dot bark. What do you say? You follow my rule. What my rule says? If you want to, this method can be called or not, go to check in bt. Hey, bt, do you have bark method? Bt means bark dog. And bark dog has already bark method, right? And definition will come from where? Definition will come from the left side. I'm sorry, right side. Right side. Somebody says right side. Definition will come from the right side. Right side means, you know, you have to go where definition new is there. So what you need to do for right side, you have to go to D. D means BD. Because you will always look from new. I told you, right? Yes. Who is created with new? So here, Like BT is pointing to D, D is pointing to BD, BD right side is Baghdad. Definition will come from the Baghdad. Please remember it. If you remember this rule, you can answer my all the questions. Mm-hmm. I'm going to ask these questions in next session also, right? So this is correct, right? So your question may be Nagend. You understand the concept of upcasting, downcasting, but we don't understand why we are learning it. What is the benefit of it, right? I'm telling you. This is the thing. This concept is going to be used throughout the Java code, because everywhere you will see upcasting and downcasting. And I'm telling you, upcasting and downcasting is basically you play a great role. And this is used to implement a concept of polymorphism. I don't know you heard about it or not. Polymorphism is another pillar of inheritance.
Yes.
So polymorphism. Hey, you tell me whatever concept we have discussed so far. Do you understand or you got confused a little bit?
Almost
it's clear, right? Okay, so guys, I'm just keeping my session till here. In next session, what we are going to do, we are going to discuss one of the very, very important concept which is being used everywhere, that is called method overriding. Polymorphism, super class keyword, right? 10. So, and after that, I will take one more session where I will teach you inheritance and abstract class. And then after that, your OOPS will be finished. So I need two more sessions to finish it. That's it. Okay. Got it? I'll share the recording, code, and this diagram also.
Okay.
Anybody have any question, any query, or whatever I have to teach you today? It's too clear. No confusion at all.
It's clear.
It's clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay, then. Fine, so we have next session on Wednesday, same time, 7 a.m. CST. Okay, so I'm just giving my session till here. Thank you so much for your time. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.